My name is Ilia Solov'yov, and I work at the Beckman Institute at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign. And one of the projects I'm really interested in is trying to understand the biophysical mechanism of the smell sense. In the nose of a human being or an animal, there are thousands of different receptors which detect small molecules which cause the sense of smell. There are different types of olfactory receptors which are tuned for different odorants. And the mechanism, how this biological function is triggered, is still not completely understood. And this is what we are trying to do here at the Beckman Institute. There are two ideas how the sense of smell works. So the first idea is a so-called shape mechanism, where the nose, all the receptor cavities can be a little bit different shape. So they could accommodate only very specific molecules. For example, if one talks about a ring-shaped molecule, it is unlikely to bind with the receptor which is supposed to detect linear-shaped molecules. So the shape is important to accommodate a specific odorant molecule in a particular receptor. But it is still a question what happens after this binding has occurred. So, and in this respect, there is another theory. The other theory is a so-called vibrationally assisted mechanism of smell. The way how it works, once an odorant molecule enters the receptor, it triggers a quantum mechanical process of electron transfer through the receptor. The idea is actually very simple. So imagine an olfactory receptor without an odorant molecule inside. It is believed that the receptor has two sites, a so-called donor site and an acceptor site. The donor site initially has an electron which tries hard to get to the acceptor site. So, and this transfer is hardly possible without the presence of an external molecule because of the energetics of the receptor. So, but once an odorant molecule is bound with the receptor, it vibrates at certain characteristic frequencies, and this vibration assists the electron tunneling from the donor to the acceptor. But even if the shape of two molecules is identical, sometimes the constituent atoms may be different. Here you can see two odorant molecules, and as you can see, they have absolutely the same shape. But because the second molecule shown here contains deuterium compared to the hydrogen here, the vibrational frequency for this molecule is lower. So even if the shape of the molecules is the same, the chemical reactions would be different. So we believe that there is a complicated interaction of these two factors, and both of them matter and are important for olfaction. An example of this was performed by a group of scientists in Greece, where fruit flies were tested in a so-called tea maze. So a tea maze is nothing more than just a glass tube, which is filled with fruit flies. And at both ends of these glass tubes, one can put two distinctly different odorants. And fruit flies choose one odorant in favor of the other one by spending more time in this glass tube closer to the more preferential odorant. But as a next step, the scientists in Greece, they took one of the odorants out, and they have modified its chemical structure by replacing all hydrogen atoms with a heavier deuterium. This modification doesn't change the shape of the odorant molecules, but it definitely changes the vibrational frequencies, because deuterium is heavier, so the molecules with deuterium vibrate at different frequency. And when they performed the experiment with the deuterated odorant and looked at the distribution of the fruit flies in this tea maze, they didn't see any preference in either the deuterated odorant or the non-modified odorant from the first experiment. So this clearly demonstrates that vibrational frequencies are somehow related to the smell sense, at least in fruit flies. The Greek paper, it is an experimental paper, so it shows a clear experiment, but it doesn't go into the details of the mechanism. In our paper, we are really interested in understanding the mechanism behind this sense. We consider the same odorants as the scientists from Greece did, and then we have calculated the vibrational frequencies for these molecules and demonstrated that for a particular vibration mode, there is a very similar electron tunneling rate through the olfactory receptor, which we indirectly could link with the main conclusion of the Greek scientists. Earlier papers that suggested this mechanism of vibrationally assisted olfaction, they were more focused on physical aspects of the problem. So what we try to do, we try to see how this mechanism can be realized in a real biological environment, biological system. So we looked carefully at the theory and try to establish the range of biophysical parameters that an receptor and also an odorant molecule should have in order for the mechanism to function. So this is definitely a new step, and so I think probably this is the most important achievement in our paper.